Wikidonis.com. Truth about tooth.
Some of the people who came to our clinics used to say that I brush my teeth. Why is the cavity there? Or I brush my teeth. Why is it that I am having gum issues? So we need to understand some things about brushing. When do you brush the teeth? See, in our country, we brush the teeth as soon as you get up. First thing you do is you get into your washroom, brush your teeth, or some people just walk around and brush the teeth around the place. They take around 15 minutes. They finish reading the newspaper with the brush in the mouth. There are so many ways of brushing the teeth, and it is one of the first things they do in the morning. Why I don't prefer that is basically most of the time you are not awake. You are just awake and you are still in a sleepy mood and you are doing something to start you off or kickstart yourself. But brushing is not something which should be done like that. It should be done carefully. If it is possible, you should do it in front of a mirror. Now, I always recommend you to start brushing after the breakfast. Why I tell after the breakfast? The breakfast is a meal which you start off and then you have around 3 hours before you take your lunch or you take your whatever food. At least 3 hours is there. So that is one way to keep your teeth off the food for some time. So I always tell that, okay, you brush your teeth in the night after dinner, not before sleepy, because that is all, because that is also one time where you are very sleepy and then you go and brush. And that is not a very good job because you are sleepy mode, so you might miss some area and you'll be missing that area regularly because you are used to it. This is all muscle memory, just like what you do while driving a car. You don't really think about what gear you are on, what clutch or brake you are stamping on. Just like that, you'll be just going and doing it. And there is every chance to miss some area and you'll be keeping on doing the same thing for quite some time. So please make sure that you brush after dinner. And from dinner to breakfast, there is a long time where there is nothing to disturb your teeth, or at least food will not disturb the teeth for next. So the food load and is off the teeth and it is time for our tooth to get repaired with saliva and the calcium to be redeposited if at all there is some decalcification already happening. So you will get at least 8 to 9 hours before if you are just taking it before sleep. But if you take it just after dinner, you might get it up to 12 hours before, between dinner and the breakfast. So that is a very good idea if at all you can do that. So in the morning, you don't have to brush because your teeth and the mouth is actually clean. So you can have your breakfast after washing your mouth, of course, and then you can take your breakfast and then do the brushing. So what will happen is after the brushing, you will get another 3 hours. So totally around 15 hours of the day, your teeth is off all the food load. So it gets enough time to get repaired and get recuperated, and then your teeth will be much more healthy. That is one reason. The second reason, the two reasons, one is actually the sleepiness, and the second thing is actually to keep the food load for quite some time. So the third reason why I tell you is that is the time. But see, just after breakfast, if you can brush and go, then your office mates and you yourself will feel that, okay, I don't have a stench in my mouth. My mouth is clean, and you will be much more confident. So that will be the right way to do before, just after breakfast and just after dinner. There are one reason why you should not do just after, if at all you are taking, there is one thing you should be careful. You should not do brushing just after breakfast or dinner if at all you are having something which is very sore, like having a fruit juice, like having Coke for dinner. Please wait for 30 to 40 minutes before you brush your mouth, because that will actually take your enamel, because your enamel is soft if it is dipped in acidic solutions, and then I don't want you to brush it off take the enamel off. So this is one more thing you should be careful. Just because I told after breakfast, you should not go, don't go rush and brush if at all you are having something very acidic. Make sure that you brush, even if you are going out and having food or breakfast outside, you will not be able to brush. So make sure that you brush and go in the morning, so that you will not miss the brushing, because teeth need to be brushed and kept clean, because the plaque which is there can get calcified if at all you delay removing it from your mouth. So make sure that you do that. See, what to use for brushing. So I'll talk about the paste and different types of paste in the next this thing, but you should use a toothpaste. You should not use any other abrasives and things like that, or like in the YouTube they speak about a lot more about other things like salt and with vinegar. Some people talk about caustic soda, some people talk about baking soda, some people talk about lime, and so many things they speak about, but it is not scientifically proved, it is not scientifically good. It all takes off your stains and things like that, but at the cost of your enamel. So please don't go through that one. Use a fluoridated toothpaste if at all you have a problem with this thing. If you are with caries, if you have a problem with caries, please make sure that you brush with fluoridated toothpaste. If you are living in a place where a lot of fluoride is there, you can use a non-fluoridated toothpaste. And to keep it very clear, fluoride is good for your tooth because it will reduce your acidic attack on tooth. But if it is ingested into your mouth, and then if it is swallowed on a large quantity, then it can cause fluorosis and brittle bone and stuff like that. I do agree, but we are not eating fluoride, but we are actually using fluoride to make your enamel much more stronger. So I personally prefer to use fluoridated toothpaste for all people who are not living in high fluoride areas. So this is what my advice towards brushing. What are the other things? We can use flossing, but you should be very careful that you don't push your food and your plaque down into the gums, because that will cause even more damage. So that has to be done. Make sure that you go to the dentist every 6 months. You can use a water flosser and to reduce your gum inflammations, if at all any. Or if you are a diabetic, please use a water flosser like Waterpik or Oral Flosser, which is available on the net. You can use, it is much better than flossing because it doesn't push your food or debris into the gums, so that's a good idea. You can use an electric brush if you are having a debilitatory issues, you can use an electric brush. I'll talk about brushes in detail in another video. I'll talk about paste and what all should not be used, what should be used for brushing in detail, so that you'll understand what exactly is each and every of them. So please subscribe my channel, and if you have some doubts about something, please let me know. I'll talk directly to you, or I'll reply to you on comment, or even I can make another video for all the people if at all it's something interesting for the rest of the people. So please keep in touch. Please watch me share this video so that people will be interested in understanding more about dentistry, understanding more about all these facts and truths about dentistry. I'm Dr. Thomas Nechupadam, signing off from Nechupadam Dental at Marine Drive, Cochin, Kerala. Kerala is a beautiful place. You can always come down, have a chat, and have a coffee with me. I'm a dentist practicing at Marine Drive. Thank you very much. Wikidonis.com.